We humans were fascinated by big organisms with lots of biomass, from the powerful breaching whales in our oceans to the giant lumbering elephants of the African savannas and the majestic ancient redwood trees of California. I mean, check out the huge amount of biomass in this tree. It's about the same as the weight of 72 adult male African elephants. But how do scientists know how much biomass this tree has? Did they cut it down, dry it in an oven to remove the moisture, and then weigh it? Thankfully, no. Instead, they climbed it and took careful measurements along its trunk and used those to estimate its biomass. And that leads me to the focus of this video, which is to tell you about a simple way that farmers can estimate their cereal cover crop shoot biomass. Now, why would a farmer want to estimate their biomass? Well, it'll tell them how much organic matter or carbon and energy that they're adding to the soil food web when they cover crop. And that's important for keeping the soil productive and healthy. But another reason is that in the region of California where I work, knowing a cover crop shoot biomass is critical because farms that produce all these nutritious, delicious vegetables can get a nitrogen scavenging credit for non-legume cover crops that grow for at least 90 days during the rainy period and produce at least 4,500 pounds per acre of oven-dry shoot biomass. That credit's an important incentive to cover cropping in a game-changing regulation called Ag Order 4.0. That regulation affects more than 500,000 acres of irrigated land in California's Central Coast region. So this past year, my friend Richard and I collected lots of data to try to figure out a method to help farmers estimate their cover crops' shoot biomass so that they could get that nitrogen scavenging credit. We wanted a method that was simple and relatively accurate, field-based, and farmer-friendly. And we focused on these two main cover crops, Merced rye, which has been around for a long time, and Pacheco triticale, which is a newer variety. We collected data from farmers' fields in three main parts of the Central Coast region, and we also did five replicated planting date experiments at the USDA Organic Research Farm where I work. Now, I'm happy to report that we figured out a real simple way for farmers to estimate their cover crop shoot biomass. Here's a figure that shows that for Merced rye. So on the x-axis, we have the average main shoot length in centimeters and in inches. And on the y-axis, we have the oven-dry shoot biomass in kilograms per hectare and pounds per acre. So there are more than 150 data points here that came from overwintered cover crops in the planting date trials at the USDA and from farms, as well as from some summer and fall cover crops. And what we found was that the cover crop's average shoot length is an excellent predictor of its oven-dry biomass. As the shoot length goes up, so does the biomass. So here's the 4,500 pounds per acre required by that Ag Order regulation that I mentioned earlier. And we can see that for Merced rye, the shoots need to be about 31 inches to reach that biomass requirement. And here's a similar figure for Pacheco triticale showing that its shoot length only needs to be about 27 inches to reach that 4,500 pounds per acre requirement in the regulation. All right, so what do I mean by main shoot length and how was it measured? Cereal cover crops like rye and triticale have a main shoot, that's the first one that grows, and then they often have several side shoots or tillers that grow from the base of the main shoot. So I'm focused on the main shoot length. Now the length of the main shoot should be measured after digging up the plant, and it's measured starting from where the crown roots begin. So here's a photo of the root to shoot junction of a rye plant that I dug up, and it shows three different types of roots. The first roots produced are the seminal roots that are attached to the seed. And then there's the crown roots where we'll start measuring our shoot length from. And then on this plant, there's also some developing adventitious roots at the first node above the soil surface. So we measure starting from the crown root all the way up the main stem to the end of the furthest thing away on that stem. And in this case, it's the head. And we'd measure right to the tip of the awns, which are these thin bristles on the head. Now, if a leaf is the furthest thing away from that crown root on the main stem, then we pull the leaf straight and then measure to the tip of that leaf. So how do you measure the stem length in a situation like this where the cover crop's main stem is bent? And it's important to measure the main stem length as if the plant was straight and didn't have any bends in it. Here's how I like to do it. You can see there's some natural bends in the stem. Those bends occur right at the node. So to measure the stem length, you need to get the measurement as if the stem is essentially straight. So what I do with my measuring tape is I go right up here and I go to the lowest crown root and put my tape there. I measure to that first bend. Then I come to the second bend, the next one there. Just kind of keep moving my way down the stem until I get all the way down to the end of the furthest thing from that crown root, and that's 121 centimeters. So how do you estimate the biomass of a field? I'll use a rye cover crop from my research here in Salinas as an example. So in this 10-acre field, I'd walk a diagonal across the field and I'd stop 10 times. Each time I stop, I'd collect one randomly chosen plant that I would measure. The way I like to do this to make sure that I'm not just choosing the biggest plants is that each time I stop, I reach down to the soil surface, I put my hand around a bunch of plants, I dig them up, I open my hand, and then I pick the plant closest to the end of my little finger, and I put it in a paper bag, and then I go to the next sampling point in the field. Once I've got all 10 plants, I use a flexible measuring tape to measure the length of the main stem on each plant. And then I calculate the average main stem length of the 10 plants and use that to estimate the cover crop's biomass using a table based on the regression curve like what I showed you earlier. So far in California, we only have tables like this for Merced rye and for Pacheco triticale. But I'm hoping to collect this type of data for some other important cereal cover crops here so that we can also have similar tables for them. What I'm also hoping is that cover crop researchers elsewhere that are already doing the hard work of collecting cover crop shoot biomass data will also start measuring main stem length of their cereal cover crops. That way we can develop similar tables for cereal cover crops and varieties elsewhere. I look forward to any questions or comments that you might have. Take care. 21 centimeters. Pretty easy. Oy. This rye pollen, man, can get to you.